Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So it has been a very long time since I filmed an eye tutorial. You guys ever go through these phases where like you just don't feel creative and you just can't come up with ideas, you have no inspiration? I've kind of been going through that little rut, but I got my hands on the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette and it has just blown my mind. Usually I don't go for high-end palettes because I just feel like, I don't know, the $40 and $50 price just really just really kind of makes me sick, just kind of physically ill. It's just so different and so original and unique from every other palette I've seen. It's just a beautiful array of red and berry tones. But today's video is going to be an eye tutorial over the eye look that I'm wearing today, which is a really, really pretty cranberry smoky eye using all shadows from the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. You can do so many different looks with this, and I do plan on doing a buttload of tutorials with it because everybody wants to see it. It's the most popular thing right now. I've really been trying to create looks that are different from what I've seen on YouTube already because I feel like people are creating the exact same thing. So I really hope you guys enjoy this look. It will look good on every eye color, every skin tone. If you guys want to see how to get this really pretty cranberry smoky eye using the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette, then please keep watching. Hey guys, so we are going to go ahead and get started. As you can see, I already have this eye over here done. Also, I'm sorry if the lighting isn't good enough. My ring light is not working right now. Please bear with me and please be patient. I am working on it. We're gonna get some new lighting very, very soon. So I hope this is up to par today. I hope you guys can see. So we're gonna go ahead and start out with the shade Golden Ochre, which is just a matte yellow shade. I'm just gonna pat this all over the eyelid just to set the eyeshadow primer. So we're gonna go into this matte purpley shade called Buon Fresco in the palette. I'm gonna put that on the crease from the inner to the outer corner. So now we're going to warm up the look just a little bit with Raw Sienna in the palette, which is just a matte, warm, tannish brown color. So we're just going to put that right in the crease in circular motions, the same way we did with Buon Fresco. So as you can see, I'm putting Raw Sienna a little bit lower than I did Buon Fresco because I want that purpley shade to be the highest, because this is mainly going to be like a purpley toned look. So this is just to add a little bit of warmth just to help everything blend out a little bit. Then I'm going to go back into that brush that I used with Buon Fresco with no extra product and just blend all that together. Okay, so now for my absolute favorite shade in the palette, I'm gonna go into Red Ochre, and this is the most beautiful red brown, and it's just such a pretty cranberry shade. So I'm just gonna put that with a big fluffy brush all over the eyelid going up to the crease. So I'm really gonna build this color up because I want it to be the main emphasis of the eye look. So even when we go back in with other shades, at the very end, we're gonna go back in with this and put this all over the eyelid again just to make sure it stands out the most. So I'm just blending this with a big fluffy brush all through the eyelid, right up to the crease, but keeping it below Buon Fresco and Raw Sienna. Okay, and then I'm gonna go back in with the brush that I used for Raw Sienna with no extra product and just blend right in the crease. So now I'm gonna go into my second favorite color in the palette. I'm gonna go into Love Letter, which is just a matte fuchsia color. And I'm just gonna put this in the outer V and going into the crease just a little bit. As you can see, it doesn't look like a bright pop of fuchsia. Like, it doesn't look like a big block of purple on your eye, but it just blends into Red Ochre and just kind of brightens it a little bit, so you really can't tell it's there other than the brightening factor of it. And then the last color I'm going to use is going to be Cypress Umber, which is just a matte deep brown shade. I'm just going to put this in the outer V just to kind of deepen it up a little bit. It's just going to give you that depth and dimension. That is pretty much it for the shadow placements. Now if you want to go back in and intensify any of the shadows, this is where you can do that. So first, I'm going to go back in with Red Ochre once again. I'm just going to put this all over the eyelid. I'm even going to cover up what I just did in the outer V. It will still show through. That's what I really love about these eyeshadows. So I'm just going to blend that all through the eyelid. And then I'm going to go back into Love Letter, which was that matte fuchsia shade, and put that right back on top of Cypress Umber. So I'm going to go back into Buon Fresco one more time and just put that all in the crease again just to intensify the purple and make it a little more purpley. And then for the inner corner, I'm going to go into the most beautiful champagne gold shade. This is Primavera, and I'm just going to put that in the inner corner and just slightly blend that into the inner part of the eyelid. And then for the brow bone, I'm going to go into Golden Ochre. I'm just going to put that right on the brow bone. And then I'm just going to take a blending brush one more time and blend right below that. So I'm going to go ahead and do the lower lash line. So this is going to be really, really simple. I'm not going to make this super difficult or anything. I'm just going to go into Red Ochre with a flat definer brush and just line the lower lash line. And then I'm going to go into a fluffy brush. I'm going to go into the brush that I used to actually apply red ochre. And I'm just going to take a little bit on the tip of my brush, cap off the excess, and just blend all of that. And then I'm just going to mix a little bit of Love Letter in there, just a little bit. I'm going to go into that same flat definer brush I used for red ochre along the lower lash line and just put this right on top, just lining the lashes, not going too far down with it. So now all that's left is eyeliner and mascara. I'm going to go ahead and go in with eyeliner. I'm going to use the Makeup Geek Gel Liner in the shade Immortal. But before I go in with eyeliner, I'm going to take a black eyeshadow. You can use any black eyeshadow, a matte one. The palette doesn't have one, so that's why I have to go to another palette. So I'm going to go ahead and line the lash line very close to the lashes with that black eyeshadow. And then I'm going to go into the gel liner and pop that right on top and make a little flick, a little wing. And I really like using a black eyeshadow first because it kind of prevents you from getting a really harsh line with your eyeliner, because I seem to do that quite a bit. It's really hard to blend out black eyeliner. Now I'm going to go into eyeliner and I'm going to use the Makeup Geek Gel Liner in the shade Immortal, and then we will do lashes. So now to finish up the look, I'm going to go ahead and go into mascara. And normally I would use a good mascara, like one that really makes my lashes look like falsies, and one that I actually really like, which would be like the L'Oreal Voluminous Butterfly Sculpt Mascara. But because it is almost 11 o'clock at night, I'm about to take this makeup off. I don't want to waste that one. So I'm going to use the Rimmel Scandalized Retro Glam, which I'm testing out, to coat my bottom and top lashes. So I'm going to go ahead and go do that, and the look is complete. Hey guys, so that is it for this look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out with me today. Thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe, follow me on all my social media. All the links are below. I hope you guys have a beautiful day. Mwah.